Hi guys, I'm Karolis Ramanauskas, a software engineer at n.exchange.io. Welcome to Smart Contracts Development Using Solidity course. I'm really excited to have you here because smart contracts have a potential to revolutionize the way business deals are made and executed, and it's super exciting to be even a small part of this revolution. For those not familiar with Solidity, Solidity is a programming language for writing smart contracts which run on Ethereum virtual machine on blockchain. It is a contract-oriented high-level language, and its syntax is somewhat similar to JavaScript. So if you are familiar with it and also some other prerequisites, which I will mention soon, you should find this course relatively easy to follow. So what are the prerequisites before learning Solidity? First of all, it would be great if you knew some JavaScript already and the basics such as variable assignments, loops, arrays, and functions. It would also be great if you had some experience with object-oriented programming concepts such as classes, methods, static and instance variables. Also, you should be comfortable with command line usage. Because we will extensively make use of it. Now, in part one of this course, we will first set up the development environment for this course. I will have three different videos for all three major platforms, which are Windows, OS X, and Linux, Ubuntu to be more specific. Then we will have a look at the data types which exist in Solidity language. After that, we will discuss the operators which operate on these data types. And then, we will inspect how to write functions and explore what type of functions exist in Solidity and how they differ. Then we will have a look at visibility of functions and variables. Visibility essentially refers to access modifiers which specify who can do what on which functions and variables. This is useful for encapsulation purposes. After that, we will discuss ERC20 token standard interface, what that's all about. And once that's done, actually implement the interface and develop our own ERC20 compliant token called dummy token. In the part 2 of this course, we will look at events and logging, and then finish implementing the dummy token fully, since it requires some events to be implemented as part of the ERC20 token standard interface. Then we will explore how inheritance and polymorphism can be used for code reusability, and after that we will look at exceptions and how to use them to make our code more robust and secure. Then we will take a look at most common security concerns in Solidity and how to go about them. And finally, we will see how to deploy our dummy token smart contract on a live Ethereum network and how to interact with it using both Truffle and Geth. So let's not wait any further and let's start learning.